Thirukkural written in short couplets of 7 words by Thiruvalluvar many centuries ago, no one knows quite how many centuries ago, has been translated into several languages of the world, and it has been translated time and time again into English, both in the form of prose, in the form of verse, rhymed and unrhymed. When I was asked by the publisher of the book, Aleph Book Company, to attempt a translation, I knew that I was doing something that has been done before and that is going to be done many, many times in the future as well. But I accepted the suggestion because there was a pull and an appeal to the book which I could not resist, like millions of those who have read the book. A translator's task is to be loyal to the text, but it is also important for the translator to go beyond loyalty to what can be called affinity, to be aligned to the meaning and not just to the form and the externals of the world. I have tried to do that, failed I think in many ways, but perhaps not altogether failed. Succeeded, I think, to the best of my ability, and I hope to the reader's satisfaction. The translation has to be from the original, but many translators do not have access to the original's language, and so they go to another translation which has been close to the original. In my case, my knowledge of Sangam Tamil was zero. My knowledge of workaday Tamil was passable. And so I had to access Thiruvalluvar's original through its masterly first English translation by G.U. Pope, who has also done the readers the great good turn of giving the original words in a concordance written in the Roman script, so that the reader can match the translation, G.U. Pope's translation, against the original. And so I was able, through Pope, to not only read Pope's translation and do my translation on the basis of Pope's translation, but also, couplet by couplet, refer to the original. Pope wrote in the English of his times. He wrote in what can be called Victorian English. It is an English which is easy to understand. But it is not an easy to understand English in terms of a relationship. One has to establish a relationship with what one reads beyond understanding the vocabulary. And Pope's English is today's vocabulary, today's idiom would call an archaic English. So it was necessary, I thought, that Pope's masterly translation should be renewed and refreshed in contemporary English. So English to English is how I would describe my translation. Victorian English to contemporary English is how I would further describe my translation. I have not tried to inject any predisposition of mine, either aesthetic or ideational. I have, however, brought into my translation something of my experience of the original, and that has to have a bhava to it. But it has to have a bhava which is like a piece of darning. You may darn, but the yarn has to be drawn from the parent fabric. Very often old books, and this can be called an old book in every sense of the term, is seen for its so-called relevance to our times. Is the Thirukkural relevant to our times would be, I think, a hackneyed question. It would not be a wrong or a bad question, it would be a hackneyed question. The more important thing to look for or to find without looking for in an old book being read today is not relevance, but resonance. And I think the Thirukkural resonates in our times, resonates powerfully with the issues of our times. helps us to see the human condition today through Thiruvalluvar's timeless eyes. We are such a large chunk of the earth and so diverse in our demographic composition that you're quite right, there is a sense of discovery of old roots in new gardens, old trees in new orchards all the time. But I think what we really have to be consciously striving for is to see how we in India are part of the evolution of human civilization, how in areas we have taken that evolution forward towards more humane order, and where we have in fact taken it back from that humane order. We have done both. And Thiruvalluvar is very frank in his analysis of the human psyche. He can be very critical of civilized society's behavior. But we have also to, in this process, approach Thiruvalluvar with open eyes, not the eyes of worship, but the eyes of understanding.